How accurate is thermography? What do you need to know? What is thermography? What's the principle of thermography? Who performs thermography? What do the colours mean in thermography? Can thermography detect heart disease? What cancers does thermography detect? What do you do to find out? In this third video in our series examining thermography testing for health, again I'm asking Australia's leading thermographer Pauline Rose the online questions about thermography in medicine, or as it's also known, digital infrared thermal imaging, or DITI, infrared thermography, or IRT, thermal imaging, or thermograms. They're all the same thing. Some questions are covered more in depth in the other videos, but some of you want brief answers, so let's ask. Our first question today, Pauline, is how accurate is thermography, say when screening the breast?
Well, research shows that thermography is accurate to the extent of about 94%. There is no such thing as a completely accurate screening device. I wish there was. But we find that thermography varies a little bit with age too. The younger woman, much more accurate if once you get over about 74 or 75. It's not as accurate then because the breast tumour divides at a very slow rate at that stage and doesn't put off much heat.
And Pauline, what is the principle of thermography?
Well, we're looking to, in many cases, get early clues that we should be looking for a problem. It also allows us to monitor treatments sometimes. If someone is under an ongoing treatment, we can screen very safely and very often with thermography, which you can't do with x-ray. You can't do a multiple of x-rays to monitor something. So it's quite useful from that point of view as well.
What do the colours mean in thermography?
Right, the colours that are normal in thermography are yellow and green. The more of those you get, the better. We're interested in the distribution of red and dark blue. Often dark blue, particularly in limbs, will mean there's poor circulation going to that area or to the heart. We don't want that to be too blue. And with the red, it depends where the patches are. If in the breasts, if they're even across both breasts, it's probably hormonal. But if it's concentrated in one spot, then we're more concerned about that. And we'll take a closer look at that.
So those thermography colours mean a lot.
Interesting thing about thermography that came in when the SARS virus was announced some years ago was they'd started to do mass screening at airports, and they've installed thermography machines at virtually all major airports in the world. And as you come through, before you get to baggage claim, you are being screened whether you know it or not.
In effect, any air traveller who's flown into a reasonable sized airport in the last 10 years will have had a thermography scan even though they weren't aware of it.
Yes.
Do you use the same thermography machines as airports?
Very much so. There might be some minor differences.
Same manufacturer?
Same manufacturer, yes.
Anything different at all?
Mine has to be much more mobile. I've got to be able to go up and down the length of the whole body.
Who performs thermography?
All the thermographers in Australia that I know have got some other form of health training originally, and then most of them have gone to the States to do their thermographic training. I went back and did my advanced training up there at Duke Medical School, which was a wonderful experience. But they're all certified through the American system, which governs most of the world.
What cancers can thermography detect?
Well, Chris, thermography doesn't detect cancers as such. What it's looking for is early warning signs and rogue heat findings in the body. Now, when we find that, we pair that up with a case history from the client, and then depending what information they both give us, I can make a suitable referral on to a specialist who will diagnose them.
Can you have breast cancer without any symptoms?
Yes, you can. Now, we find that quite often on screening, and also we refer on then and get second opinion screenings.
Can thermography detect heart disease?
Yes, it can, in fact. It's slightly better at doing this in men than it is in women, simply because of the anatomy. But we've had some quite spectacular heart findings amongst men. I mean, I could show you a picture of that if you wanted me to.
Yes, please, Pauline, and maybe a few other men watching might want to see this as well.
This is a gentleman, and you can see there's some very marked blue colouring all around the heart area, which he shouldn't have, and that's showing a very poor flow of blood through the heart. He didn't come in with heart symptoms, but when I questioned him about this, like a lot of men, he'd been ignoring certain symptoms he'd been getting. And I was fairly worried when I saw this. I thought this is going to blow any minute. And I, in fact, sent him straight to the hospital that day. And I said, I want you to go straight to the emergency department and ask for a cardio checkup. And he had a quadruple bypass the next day. That was the biggest bunch of flowers I ever got in my life. When he was discharged and was walking around happily again, he came in with this huge, huge arrangement of flowers for me. It was wonderful.
So, actually, you pretty much saved his life.
Pretty much on that case. But I've had two men that I've sent straight to hospital with heart findings. Others, we wait and get the specialist's opinion.
Well, thanks, Pauline, for qualifying how accurate is thermography. And I'll come back with the last set of questions in the fourth video showing what do you do to know about thermography.